I have a number of clients that come to us with declining hormone levels and decline in performance in the bedroom. Did you notice a change in your own libido and your own physical prowess, if you will?
Absolutely. The sexual function definitely was taking a hit,
yeah.
And that improved within just the first couple of weeks.
Yeah.
And that's what I'm going to talk about today.
About
men's sexual health and heart disease and how the two are tied together.
So oftentimes a man with ED or erectile dysfunction, the smaller blood vessels in the male organ clog up, and it's a sign, an earlier sign than before they even clog up in the heart or simultaneously, right?
Yes, it precedes heart disease by about 5 years. Mm-hmm. So I think it's incumbent upon all physicians that take care of men to first of all find out if they have ED, if they have erectile dysfunction.
Yes.
You know, it's a very common problem in America. And that's the first job of a physician is to get a guy to talk about this. And I think we in A4M are in a really good position to do that, because many of our male patients come to us for that reason. They don't really tell you that unless you start talking to them.
Till the end of the conversation or the patient interview, right?
Right. And so it's the physician needs to really delve into this and get him to talk about his sexual function. Mm-hmm. And if he has ED, then it's really our responsibility to make sure it's not due to vascular disease.
Right.
It's not a sign of early vascular disease.
Now, a simple EKG or a treadmill may miss a legitimate diagnosis. You really have to do more sophisticated diagnostic testing, right?
That's right. You have to do blood work. Mm-hmm. And then I talk about the different approaches to diagnosing vascular disease.
I know there's a tendency right now to throw out the baby with the baby wash, the whole thing of that cholesterol's unimportant. But from your education with Dean Ornish and the published literature, clearly there's a direct correlation to total cholesterol levels, dietary intake, and the amount of atherosclerosis not only in the heart, but throughout the vasculature and in the male organ. It's undeniable, isn't it?
Yes. You know, I think the big cause of vascular disease is inflammation, but that directly relates to plaque formation.
Mm-hmm.
And the soft plaque is the dangerous plaque that can the inflammation can erode into the lumen of the blood vessel, which forms a clot right away, and that's what causes a heart attack.
I know there's people out there, Dr. Jeff Life, who think, well, we have to take in a dietary source of cholesterol. My understanding, Guyton Medical Physiology and other textbooks, shows that the body creates its own cholesterol, even if you don't consume it from a dietary source, that the liver produces the most. Every cell of the body can make cholesterol. So we maintain usually an optimum range when we look at third world countries. But when we look throughout the world, countries that consume a large amount of dietary cholesterol in fish, chicken, eggs, and meat, they have atherosclerosis, they have higher cholesterol levels. The two are totally related.
That's right.
Now, if you don't take in a dietary source of cholesterol, say you move away from a meat, dairy, egg-based diet, and you embrace more of a plant, whole food diet, will your hormones be okay, but you still have an aging situation regardless? You still have to augment hormones, correct?
Yes, I mean, men's ability to make testosterone declines because their testicles, you know, lose their ability to make testosterone. Now, with a lot of men, their ability to maintain growth hormone levels is not compromised. As you know, diet and exercise really play a big, important role in maintaining growth hormone production. And so growth hormone deficiency can usually be corrected through diet and exercise. A vegan diet does not adversely impact growth hormone levels.
Right.
But there is a subset of people in this country that just cannot make growth hormone. And these are the people that need to be diagnosed as growth hormone deficient. And I do that through a glucagon stimulation test.
Yes.
and then treated with growth hormone.
Now, some of the lifestyle medicine physicians somehow either didn't look at the studies closely about the importance of augmenting human growth hormone, which should be a vitality hormone, maybe rather than just called growth hormone, because we think of it as a young child growing and needing more growth hormone. But as we age, we still need growth hormone or the vitality hormone. And more importantly, that hormone works directly with other hormones synergistically to help the body to function properly.
Absolutely. You know, if you are growth hormone deficient mm-hmm. and you can't correct it through exercise and nutrition, then you are doomed to a life of increased risk for all the age-related diseases, mm-hmm. Depression, and an early death, premature death.
Yes, and quality of life suffers, but besides premature death, I mean, what could be worse? So, you know, the lifestyle medicine doctors were concerned that augmenting growth hormone in deficient people or those who had higher IGF levels, there was some, in their opinion, correlation to increased rate of cancer, but we've seen those studies, and even in acromegaly, people who produce excess amounts of human growth hormone, they don't have an increased rate of cancer, and even in those over the age of 60, and except for maybe colon cancer, but we don't know what their diet was, a giant, how much food do they eat, what do they eat, what's going on in their gut. So the reality is, I think it's an unfounded concern that I think what they're looking at is after a person has cancer, IGF levels might go up in an inflammatory response. So that might have been confused.
Could be. There's not a study that I know of out there that shows that growth hormone supplementation increases one's risk for cancer.
Yeah. What is your goal for the optimum quality of life? What are you going to continue to do to achieve your ideal goal? Are there certain nutraceuticals, certain herbs, certain compounds that you've added to your regime to optimize your health and quality of life?
I think the B vitamins are very important.
Yes.
Especially if you're on a vegan diet.
Yes.
I think just a general multivitamin is important. Mm-hmm. I think fish oil is important.
Could you do omega algae possibly just at higher dosages to,
sure.
to match?
Sure.
Okay.
And then, you know, the key in my mind for healthy aging is, first of all, realize you don't have to follow the same path that your parents followed.
Right.
That we don't have to get old as we age. So my whole thing is just to not get old, stay youthful, and that's through the right kind of exercise, which includes flexibility, stretching, resistance training, and cardio training. Mm-hmm. And then eating. Eating is the deal. What you put in your mouth is can make or break your I mean, I think people need to look at what they're putting into their mouth as that this can kill them or can heal them. And if you look at that with every bite, everything you drink, then that really changes the way you approach your diet. And that's the number one thing that derails patients from really achieving a healthy lifestyle and a quality of life and reducing disease.
Dr. Life, social connection, love, positive emotions, is that an important role in maintaining telomere length and quality of life?
Very much so, and Dean Ornish studied that mm-hmm. and showed that you can actually reverse telomere shortening mm-hmm. through the right kind of diet, the right kind of exercise, love and support, and stress management. And that's really important because as the telomeres get shorter, the cells age. And if you can stop the shortening, then the cells won't age.
And through intense exercise, consistent regular exercise, you reduce free radical damage, oxidative stress, and you basically set the stage for a healthy structure in body and mind. They're all connected, aren't
right.
they?
Right, absolutely.
Yeah. Dr. Life, excellent. What is your website so people can find
it's
you?
www.drlife.com.
Excellent, drlife.com. Dr. Nick Delgado, Simply Healthy TV, thanking Dr. Life, and stay healthy.
Thank you.